Welcome back to the Talos Principle. There's two more puzzles to do in this place, and I still need to find the star. So, let's get to it. Let's do this one. Rapunzel. That is a reference to something in the real world that I forgot. If I knew what that was referencing exactly, that might give me a hint on how to solve this. I still need to actually find where the star is, let alone how to get it. I'm almost certain that it involves that new platform thing, though. Because that thing can get you a lot of places. Wait, use. Oh, that's a key. I could barely see it because of the freaking light on it. It was so intense. Yoink. Interesting. I wonder what it's used for. Well, if it's anything like the other ones, there's probably some sort of a binocular system. And it's probably somewhere nearby. Actually be able to make it by jumping from little platform to platform up there. Obviously not how you're intended to do it, but I'm curious. I mean, you definitely make the distance, it's just a matter of controlling yourself and not falling off. Anyway, forget that for now. Two boxes, nice. I guess the issue is that I can't bring them up the ladder. Okay, two boxes, a platform, and a recorder. So what's the platform for this time? Can I put a box on the platform and then pick up the platform? No. So the platform is only for standing on. So I think this is just to get the boxes up the ladder. I think that's it. No, that doesn't work. Alright, well, if it's not for that, then what is it for? Need to get more familiar with the platform. I've only really used it once. I can stand on it, I can hold an item and stand on it. I can't put an item on it, though. I mean, well, hold on. Maybe I can. Let me see. Okay, I can. You can't put an object on the platform when it's on the ground, but you can when it's actually being held. So in that case, it's not for carrying me, it's for carrying the boxes. So, I guess... wait, where should I do this? Shit. How do I get both up there? I need to get this inside. Oh, I guess we can just do this. That's not gonna work. What? How am I gonna get my recording outside? Shit. Getting one. Okay, let's just do one. Whatever. Just do one. We'll see what happens. So go like this, and then we go, Yeah, we could even jump, actually. Just to ensure that we can reach it from the top. Jump for me. Thank you. But what about the second one? I need to make the recording with it here. So we do this, and then this. And then we go over here. Okay, I think it'll work. Son of a bitch, come back! Asshole! And now my box is in there. Ugh. Oh no. This is bad. I don't have to get my other box to go get my other box. Ugh. Fuck! Okay, I guess we can do both or something. Can we? Yeah, we can do both. Alright, I'm gonna jump longer this time.
If this trial seems impossible to overcome, have no fear. Return another time, and the answer may reveal itself.
Not even close to impossible. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's do more. All right, that better be long enough. Fall off. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. This is finicky as hell. I hope this is actually how you're supposed to do it. Because finickiness can be indicative of you maybe not solving the puzzle in the intended way. Or maybe they just didn't design it very well. I don't know. Really could be either. I missed it. Oh my god. Oh my god. Stop. I guess I shouldn't be all the way in the wall. Okay. We got it this time. Thank you. Fuck me, that was harder than it should have been. Not hard to figure out what to do, just hard to actually execute it. Okay, so now I know I can stand on two boxes. And I could have myself take I anywhere. So where does me want to go? Nowhere. Let's come back to that later. That fits under the category of special stuff. Not ready for that yet. Still need to find the star. Ooh, this one looks complicated. A ditch and a fence. Well, I'd say that name was appropriate. There is a ditch, and there's a fence. The ditch is obviously for the platform. So, actually, this looks really easy. Yeah, no problem. Just do this. Leave it there for about 5 seconds. Wait until 10 seconds. Yeah, there's, that's good, and then we walk over here. And where do I need to stand? I guess, like, here? No! So close. Wait, if that doesn't do it, then what does? I mean, I could jump, but then it would only activate for like a fraction of a second, right? I could try it. Let me try a bunch of different angles. Let me see if it connects anywhere. This should be fun to watch. Laser beam is just gonna be going all over the place. Need to bind that alternative use key. Away! What the fuck? Dicks. Alright, well that's useless. Stop. The box just got thrown. What if I could make use of that at some point? Probably not here, but at some point. Okay, well, let's just try it again, I guess. Okay, so let's just not go directly up against a wall. Because I knocked it off before. Don't fall! Ah! 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 So close. Alright, let's see if it falls. Oh, it got caught. Well, oh, hello, star. There you are. There you are. Can I fit through that? There's no way I can fit through that. And I know from experience that I can't duck even an inch. But just in case, let's try. Okay, and then I want to try something else. Let me see if I can just jump over this thing. Yeah, I can't fit. God, if only I could crouch. Not quite. Now, I can stand on that, which means I can actually put this connector up on something while standing. Is there something I could put it on? Like, what about here? It wouldn't be high enough. I actually don't get it. This is obviously a pretty simple puzzle, because there's not much here. I mean, there's a lot of different tools, but the actual puzzle space is relatively limited. What's over here? Anything? I mean, well, wait a minute. If I can get here, then my clone can get here. So... yeah, I guess that's it. Just do it again, and this time go up there. That doesn't feel like what you're supposed to do, but it's gonna work. I guarantee it. If it doesn't fall off, I might be too close. Oh, you know what? I'm probably too close. It's probably gonna fall off. Yeah, I think it's gonna fall off. Shit. Shit. We'll see. Actually, let's try this instead. I'm almost certain it's gonna fall off, but I think I can make it stay if I do this. Oh god, I can actually jump inside. Let's not do that. Okay, if I do this... oh, this is not the side I want to be on. Fuck! Oh hey, it's fine. Yay! No, it closed! Shit! Alright, that is not what you're intended to do, right? There's no way. There's no freaking way. So what are you intended to do? I don't get it. I can solve it that way, but I don't think you're supposed to, which means I don't really want to do it that way. The fact that I've confirmed that you can do it that way is really cool, that's satisfying, but the trouble with that is that if you learn how to do something the wrong way, then you don't necessarily learn what the puzzle's trying to teach you, which means other puzzles tend to become harder, because it expects you to know the thing that it thinks it taught you, but it didn't actually teach you. So, yeah. That ain't good. There's no way you're supposed to do that. There's no way you're supposed to get up on here. It's too close, the thing will probably fall off. It's too easy to fall off. No. No way. But how else do you get height? Oh, you just stand on the box, don't you? You just stand on the box. The ghost box. Yeah. Okay, got it. It's really hard to combine all these rules, because there's a lot of rule sets you have to think about at the same time. Like, you have to think about the fact that, oh, I can put a box down and stand on it when I'm in a recording, and then I can take that box when I'm not in the recording, and it won't mess up the box, because the box will still be there in the recording. Mixing that with this platform, and... oh, I can put stuff on the platform, but it kind of falls off sometimes, but most of the time it doesn't, and there's a lot of things to consider. Starting to get the hang of the platform, though. Yeah, that's neat. See, I was originally thinking that I have access to another box when I'm doing a recording, right? That blue box. But then I was thinking in terms of I need more height for the beam. So I was trying to think of ways to somehow stack the blue box on the non-blue box to make more height, but you can't do that. Because the blue box doesn't appear until you're done with the recording, not during the recording. So you need the actual doubling of the box to happen after the recording, not before or during. So that's why the recording needs to stand on the extra box, and then you need to take the other box and put it on top of them. Like a recording sandwich. Interesting.
Your wisdom grows, but be wary of temptation.
Okay, well, now I have 10 stars, which means I can open up the next star room, which is really cool. Let's see. I wonder if there's anything more here. I mean, I've solved every puzzle, I found the star, and I found one Easter egg. Usually there's not too many Easter eggs, especially in an environment this small, but there maybe could be one more? I don't know. And there's definitely a massive opportunity to go out of bounds, which I have not made use of yet. So I'm going to take a look around this level, see if I can find anything, and I'll be right back. Okay, well, first other Easter egg, which I forgot about when I was mentioning that I wasn't sure if there's any more Easter eggs, is the binoculars. Yeah, I picked up the key for that, so obviously that does indicate there is another Easter egg. And it turns out it's up here. Getting up there seems to be a little bit tricky, but I think I found a way. So if I jump up here, jump onto a stack of two boxes, there is coincidentally that little ledge right there.
Hint, it's no coincidence. The level designers put it there on purpose.
Now, you can't quite jump over, but, oh, don't fall. You can jump onto this. There we go. Alright, so what is this looking at? Looks like the mountains. Yeah, there's something on that mountain up there. I wonder what it is. Hello. It's a monster. Is he gonna do something? Maybe if I look at it long enough, it'll do something. Is it watching me? Looks like the same kind of monster that I reconstructed the statue of. That, or it's like a Yeti. See if there's anything else out there. Probably not, because in the past I've only found one thing when looking through this. No, I think that's it. Okay, let's just briefly look and see if there's anything out of bounds here. Oh, shit! Didn't expect that bounce. That kind of screws everything up, because now I'm trapped and I have to reset. Shit. Alright, well, this is a relatively small area, and I just found two Easter eggs, so honestly, that's probably it. Yeah. I feel pretty confident calling this place done. Okay, well, I think it's time to go unlock the Star Room in Puzzle Hub B. Alright, let me see if I can do this one quickly. Probably doesn't go like that. No, that seems pretty doubtful. No, that's not gonna work. No way. Hey! Oh my god. It actually worked.
Before the Age of Chaos, there were other gods. Old gods. But for all their power, they could not save their world. Thus, I was made. And I shall preserve this world forever, for you and your generations. That is my purpose.
Aw, Elohim, you're so nice. So giving. What a caring god. Okay, so the last star room had, I think it was like 9 star, and this one is star 8 star, so this is obviously giving me the parts of a password. And it's 3 digits long, which is also as long as the last password was to unlock level 3 of the tower. So I think this is the password to one of the levels on the tower. Although I don't know which one. And another image, huh? Wait a minute. I thought there were 7 levels on the elevator. Aren't there 7? That only goes to 6. I could have sworn there were 7. I don't know. I'll have to check again. I'm gonna write a note. 6 floors? Question mark? Orangutan. A medical journal has published a startling new theory about last year's sudden, shocking extinction of the orangutan. See our award-winning video of the last orangutan at this link. They suggest that the virus responsible was not a new mutation, but a very old one. An ancient virus buried, until now, in high-latitude permafrost, set free by global warming. The virus may have plagued the ancestors of the modern great apes more than 100,000 years ago. Several important questions remain unanswered, including something. More importantly, the study suggests that, based on samples taken from locations around the globe, the something incubation period may be... If you like this article, you may also like How to Really Avoid Heart Attacks. You won't believe what's living under this rock. Top 10 Amazing Science Facts. Oscar's Nip Slip Explained by Physics. Last year's sudden shocking extinction of the orangutan. Potentially set free by melting high-latitude permafrost. Could that be what caused the sudden extinction of the human race? Perhaps it didn't just affect the orangutans, maybe it did at first. But then perhaps it mutated or something, and started affecting us. And to think that it was caused by, basically, climate change causing it to melt when it normally would not melt. Oh man, that's a whole lot of things bundled up into one. And not only the extinction of the human race, but that could be the extinction of the human race, caused in part by their own hand. Usernames. From George Jameson, Ian mailing list regarding usernames. It's, working now. Each iteration is assigned its own unique name, drawn randomly from the database. At the moment, there's a database, that's a database of online gaming handles, which does sound a bit odd, but I honestly don't think we should spend more time on this. We have unique identifiers, so we're fine. More than that is a luxury we can't afford. If we should happen to have everything else finished on time, I'll go back and generate a new database with more appropriate names. Right now, it just can't be a priority. So is that where all the names for the different AIs comes from? And how weird they are? Like, dog, shepherd, all sorts of other weird stuff. Blake Archive. The ancient poets animated all sensible objects with gods or geniuses, calling them by the names and adorning them with the properties of woods, rivers, mountains, lakes, cities, nations, and whatever their enlarged and numerous senses could perceive. And particularly they studied the genius of each city and country, placing it under its mental deity, till a system was formed, which took some advantage of and enslaved the vulgar by attempting to realize or abstract the mental deities from their objects. Thus began priesthood, choosing forms of worship from poetic tales. And at length they pronounced that the gods had ordered such thing. Let's misspell, what? Thus men forget that all deities reside in the human breast. Okay, this is either filled with weird spelling mistakes, or this is really old English. Ordered without an E? All deities reside in the human breast? That is a very strange phrase. But it's talking about the ancient poets, so I would think it's relatively modern. I have no idea. Anyway, I think it's about time to end this episode, but before that, I really want to know about the elevator thing. So let me go check that real quick. So the picture showed 6 different levels. Oh, there is actually only 6. Huh. Okay, so in that case, what does the image show? I mean, what is it trying to tell me? So the first image was showing the tower. It was just a side view of the tower, just like looking up, like this. The second one is of the elevator. Maybe the image is basically just telling me what floor the password's for, right? Because I don't know what floor the password's actually for. So maybe when I get the last part of the password, the final image will show me, like, the person going to one of the floors, and that's telling me where to put the password. I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Alright, well, I am going to go explore the Star Room in the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.